Do you have friends who are climate science deniers? Well, slap a smile on that face and listen up, because we're here to help you school them. Hey y'all, Trace here for DNews with some ammunition you need when someone cites the severe winter that we've had this year as a reason that there's no such thing as global warming. The most important thing to get across is today doesn't mean a load of bantha crap. It's trends that matter. Climate is weather over time, and as time marches on, the climate has changed, thus climate change. That change happens to be a warming trend, and thus why they call it global warming. Again, the weather is happening today, and that doesn't really tell us what's happened over the last several dozen years. Though earlier this year it was colder in Manitoba, Canada than it was on Mars, in Australia they're getting the hottest temperatures ever, in the same year at the same time. So rather than quoting anecdotes and then laughing, why don't you bring the data? According to the University Corporation for Atmospheric Research, we're experiencing more record highs than ever before, indicating we are on a warming trend, not to mention the overall global temperature, which is currently a balmy 57.9 degrees Fahrenheit, making this year globally the 8th hottest year on record. By the way, all 10 of which have been since 1998. Again, getting hotter. That alone might not convince a lot of people, because most will hit back with disagreements among climate scientists. This is when you mention Albuquerque. From 1991 to 2012, there were nearly 14,000 peer-reviewed published scientific papers exploring climate science. 24 of those said global warming is fake. To put that in perspective, that's like saying every person in the United States agrees with climate change, except the population of Albuquerque. Silly Albuquerque. If a movie had 98% approval, would you go see it? There are more people who hated WALL-E than there are climate scientists denying climate change. Have you ever met someone who hates WALL-E? Me either. Now keep smiling during your friend's rebuttal about how the climate is cyclical and we can't possibly know because we weren't there. At this point, you can throw them off by agreeing, because they're right. The climate is cyclical. 100 million years ago, the tropics stretched from Alaska to Antarctica. Then it cooled off. 55 million years ago, it was hot again. Temperatures rose by 6 degrees Celsius in 20,000 years because of massive methane release. Then it cooled again. And finally, a report by NASA from 2012 says that 20 million years ago, Antarctica had trees. And then it cooled again. All this is absolutely true. We are on a cycle of boom and bust, just like in economics. But based on the study of fossil evidence corroborated by ice cores from Antarctica, the boom of heat that we're on right now is going way faster than it should be. Normally, barring an asteroid impact, major volcanic ash cloud, or some other global disaster, this cycle is millions of years long. So really, they're actually proving your point by saying it's cyclical, because we just came out of an ice age 60,000 years ago, and unlike a slow plodding increase in temperature, in this warming, the heating has sped up in the last 100 years. Finally, while your worthy opponent reels from you showing them how their own evidence supports your claims, make sure you mention global warming isn't really the best term. It's actually climate change, because we have to look at these changes over lifetimes. And while yes, the globe is warming, it's also gonna cool off, causing more snow, more ice, more drought, and generally more extreme weather. Some lawmakers are pushing to change the term to global climate disruption, but that's just another title. The important thing is, nobody hates WALL-E, but until we learn to work with nature, no one wants to live on his planet either. What do you think? Let me know your thoughts on our Facebook, Twitter, and Google Plus pages, or leave a comment down below. Thanks a lot for watching DNews today, everybody. Subscribe and stay cool out there.